Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and today I'm gonna tell you some words, some hints, some ideas about the movie, very famous movie, Independence Day, first and the second part also, including Resurrection. And it's nice movie, except such moments. What kind of vibration we can see in space? Strange. And what kind of noise in space? That's bullshit. But okay, let's get to the point. And unfortunately, you cannot see, cannot understand what this lady is saying. I was making some kind of regression, some kind of hypnosis regression, and some sleepers. People who could see, good vision, told us the same story. That's what happened in 19th century. That's exactly what happened according to this movie. First invasion, second invasion, and I think this movie is documentary because it's proved by some sleepers, some people who can see. I put 3 videos on my Russian channel. Unfortunately, it's too huge amount for translation, but it's exactly what is explained in this movie. First invasion, second, and what's going on, and how we try to communicate with our enemy, everything like in fairy tale in from Sochi, and Star Force also, everything is shown there indirectly, like destruction of ancient so-called Greco-Roman style buildings, and about physiology, like you know they have the same metabolism and the same bodies, very vulnerable bodies, and so on. Many hints. And the way we negotiate, the way they contact from us, they contact us, we contacted them. And there is no way we can communicate with them because they are totally different and their mind is totally different. Mind of our enemy is totally opposite to our mind, our way of thinking, our values, and so on. And I will try to explain it observing this movie. What they want us? They want us to die, as it says here. Simply die. They use us as battery to supply energy with our suffering and so on. Would you ready? And I will show you more in many videos on my channel. They are really like locusts. They just suck, wipe out our planet and so on, and people, and they move on. They destroyed their civilization, their universe, and they have come to us. It's real, pure evil. I think their time is over. We now realize who the enemy is. And this is a good movie because it shows end. But why enemy is showing us happy end? To prevent the materialization in this reality. And in second movie, this movie in Resurrection is showing us how everything happened in second time. It shows that any purpose, any person ever contacted our enemy telepathically is still in the contact for entire life until the end. It's also a strange moment why, let's call it Afro-American, hurts white man. Why they put it here? And white man explains, and Chinese guy, it's like supervisor, like a judge. He's beyond the battle. Strange. And this is also a very interesting moment. Also, guy in contact with you, but he was like sleeping from the first invasion to the second one. And they show that enemy, our enemy, has own enemies. And as my conclusion is, enemy of our enemy is our friend. We are not only free guys in the other universe. Somebody is fighting against our enemy. The force captured us in 19th century and still holding. And what is also interesting there is Chinese language, Chinese flag, only American flag, of course, it's Hollywood, and Chinese flag in there, openly, huge flag. It also means something. What do you think about it? Why? Because there is no coincidence in such movies. And emblema, the symbol of our friend, the force fighting against our enemy, about this hive. Also interesting information. When they come, they suppress people in contact with them, so people can feel enemy. An enemy can press and telepathically destroy our brains. And the size, like in our session of regress, and our defense, everything is explained in reality how it was. It's not fantasy. So I have many proofs that this movie is documentary, really. That's exactly how it happened in 19th century, in the beginning of 19th century. Because the mothership was really huge. Huge like a continent. It's strange why White House survived, it was destroyed in the first part. But that's okay. Let's think that they forgot about it. Just a mistake. Okay, guys. What do you think about it? Is it really a documentary? What do you think about these sessions which I showed in Russian channel? Because this lady tells everything in details what I picked up in many, many sources, from many sources in many places. And please, this movie, watch this part, the so-called negotiation and what president was saying during the contact and how enemies look. That's exactly how this lady explained everything. This lady didn't see this movie and many other movies, but she explained everything in details. I was part of it. I didn't tell her anything, but she explained everything what happened in details. I was really shocked. If you have someone to translate Russian, please ask and watch sessions on my Russian channel. It's gonna be interesting for you. And it's really like hive, and she's in the center of it. She's center of brain, hive mind, and so on. And this queen of the hive is really everything. Please, there are many hints and details about our enemy and the own universe inside ecological systems, they call, but it means that they have laws of another dimension, another universe inside it. So they cannot deal directly with our dimension, our vibrations, and so on. They tell you openly, just learn how to watch. All you need, open your eyes, turn off your brain, and listen. Everything in this movie. Some details I point out, you will see these episodes and you will watch it. All dialogues, it's all about all universe, really. Our enemy has enemies, and so on. Our enemy is not invulnerable. There are some ways to destroy it. There are some weaknesses. And they are open. Openly tell us in this movie what is the weakness of our enemy and who is the leader and how they think, how they communicate with us, and about frequencies, signatures, and so on. Really, the core they use and so on. Why are we so interesting for our enemy, what they did to our planet before in 19th century, and so on. Really, they wanna hide it. If you wanna hide it, something, put it on plain sight. That's what our enemy is doing. Telling openly, showing happy end, which didn't exist in reality, and call it science fiction. It's the best way to hide it. So another way to hide it, call it science fiction. Really. And in this movie, in science fiction genre, we see what really happened, like in many other movies, but about the same topic. And this movie shows the weaknesses of our enemy. This movie also shows the result. And in another movie, Game of Thrones, the serial, the dragon also just left, the final dragon, the last one. And also we have some hope, because I think we can get some support, we can get cooperation, some kind of cooperation and informational support, some information from enemies of our enemy. I think we are not the only human civilization who wants to be free and fight against our enemy. So I think we have the hope. And exit in the triangle, like in many other movies, like in The Giver and Oblivion and so on. I hope this will really happen next time.